Welcome to Pet Pals. I'm Bethany Davidson, your host. I'm the Humane Educator here at Frederick County Animal Control and Pet Adoption Center. And joining me, as always, is fan favorite and animal wrangler extraordinaire, Randy Cooper. This week, we have a lot more dogs than we had last week. We got some new additions to the floor, as well as a returning guest. And we've got all new cats for you as well. Starting out today, we have Bella. Even though she's been at the shelter for, a week to 2 weeks, this is her first appearance here on Pet Pals, because last week she had been spayed and she wasn't feeling great. And now she's feeling much better, and she's happy to be here today. She is a 1 to 2 year old pit bull mix. She's got that great black and tan coloring, that kind of shepherd look to her. And she is a very friendly, very outgoing girl, but she still has a lot of those types of puppy behaviors that were never really worked on for her. So she's going to need an owner who is going to be willing to put in the time to train her, to get her all of those basic manners things down. She does know sit, and she has a nice sit that she does. She takes treats pretty gently, she jumps and she pulls on her leash. So those are things that she needs to work on. And it's just going to take a little time for her to learn those things. But Bella is very friendly. She just needs someone who's going to be patient and teach her good manners and the best way to behave. We saw her here. She tries to kind of chew on leashes. All of those things are kind of puppy behaviors that she was just never taught. Were unacceptable before, but she has a lot of potential, and she is going to make a great addition to anyone's life. Next up, we have Emmy, and she is a 4 to 5 year old Jack Russell Terrier mix. Her coloring is unique. It's the blue merle, and she's got the cutest face. Those ears just, they're super cute. They're the first thing that I see when I look at her. She's got a lot of energy, like many of the dogs here. So when you're thinking about taking home a dog, especially one that's got, that Jack Russell, and they're a high energy dog, so they're gonna need a lot of walks, they're gonna need a lot of outside playtime to burn off that energy. Just because they're a small dog doesn't mean that they would necessarily be a great dog to sit in the house all day and not get that outdoor exercise, those runs and things like that in. So you have to be really cautious when you're do your research and really think about it when you're adding a dog to your home to make sure that it's the type of breed that you have enough time for. If you live in a small space but you have time to get her out and get her to the dog park and go for walks with her, then that's fine. But if you have the situation where she's not going to be able to go run in your yard and you don't have time to take her out, she's going to be crated a lot, that might not be the best fit for you or for her. So there's a lot of things to consider when you're taking on a new pet. So you want to make sure that they can fit in your home. If you have a small apartment, then maybe a big husky or something like that might not be the right fit for you. You have to know whether you have the time to give it the exercise like we've just talked about. All of those types of things, whether they're going to get along with your other dogs, if they're going to get along with your kids, there's a lot of things to take into consideration. That's partly why we want everyone who lives in your home to visit with an animal before we adopt them out, to make sure that it is a fit, good fit, to make sure that for some reason, maybe a dog doesn't get along with your child, or your child is afraid of the dog. We also encourage those dog to dogs, like I was talking about with Bella, so that we can make sure that the dogs are going to be a good fit and mesh well together. If you're looking for someone, for a dog that's going to love you, like Emmy here is falling in love with Randy, then stop by and visit her here at Frederick County Animal Control. This little bundle of energy is Raven, and he is a 1 to 1.5 year old Yorkie mix. We do have him listed down as being adopted through our puppy process, even though he's an adult dog. That puppy process means that we're going to take up to 4 applications for Raven, who we're calling Raven Rocks, because we have another Raven on the floor right now. And we're going to do some, ask some additional questions of potential adopters. We're going to do some additional checks to make sure that we find a good home for Raven. The reason that we're doing that is because Raven has a lot of energy, so he's going to need somebody who's going to get out and get him that exercise like we've been talking about for Emmy. But Raven has much more energy than Raven does. Also, we had a trainer who had previously worked with him, and she brought us some information as far as things that will be helpful for him. So, he needs some basic manners training. He can nip a little bit, which was one of his owner's concerns. So he needs some work with those types of things. And he, you know, it says in the paperwork that she provided with us that he was a dog that came from a puppy mill, and that he's already, you know, the owner that surrendered him was his second owner. So this trainer was concerned that he's going to become a serial surrender. He's going to need some training. So we want to make sure that we're going to find the right home for Raven, so that he doesn't have to go through being a shelter dog again, so that he's going to find a home where they're going to give him the training that he needs. They're going to be patient with him, and he's going to end up in his forever home instead of ending up in our shelter or another shelter somewhere down the line. So that's why we're putting him through that puppy process. If you think that Raven is going to be a great addition to your family, then you can stop by and visit him here at Frederick County Animal Control and Pet Adoption Center. We're located at 1832 Rosemont Avenue. Our last new guest is going to be Milo, and he is a tricolor Aussie mix. He's 5 years old. He came to us previously owned. His owner could no longer have a pet, so they brought him to us, which was the responsible thing to do. If you're unable to keep your pet, unable to find someone else to take them in, it's much better to bring them to us so that we can find them new homes than to leave them in your home when you're moving, or let them go out as strays. We want to make sure that all the animals in Frederick County are safe. So if you can't keep them, bringing them to us is the best option for them. However, there are resources out there for people who need help to be able to keep their pets. You can contact the Frederick County Humane Society if you have some issues, because they might be able to help you out with some of their programs so that you can keep your animal in your home instead of having to bring them to us. Which was the case with Milo here. Milo is adorable. You walk by his kennel, he's always got a smile on his face. He sits right at the door to greet you, but he can be a little bit shy. The more he gets to know you, the friendlier he is. He's just a little cautious around new people and new situations. But when he walks past the other dogs, he has no reaction. He's just takes a little bit of coaxing to get him to come out sometimes. Milo walks very well on the leash, but things that we know about him since he's been here, he's not a fan of people touching or being near, messing with his mouth or his nose. So that's why we've marked him down as a kennel tech or approved volunteer only, and older children in adult home only as well, for the reasons that we've already talked about on the show today. Other things that we want people to know about Milo, things that might be obvious, aside from his great personality and the fact that he loves to be petted and wants to be treated with affection, he's going to sit right by your side. He's a little bit overweight. So if you were to adopt Milo, you would want to keep him on a diet to get him down to a healthy weight. Always consult your vet when you're thinking about putting any of your pets on a diet, because you want to make sure that they're losing weight at a healthy rate. Just like with people, if they lose it too rapidly, that can be unhealthy as well. But Milo is a very sweet dog. Because he does have a longer coat, he is going to need some grooming. Just like Raven, who was on the show before him, is also going to need some grooming. Those are things that you also want to take into consideration when adding pets to your home? Are you able to keep up with their grooming, their exercise needs? Because he's a little overweight, he is going to need a little more exercise so that we can get him slimmed down. But he's very sweet, very affectionate. He's much calmer than some of the other dogs that we've had on the show today. So if you're looking for just a nice, sweet guy to keep you company, you can stop in and visit with Milo here at Animal Control. This is our last guest. This is Harley, and he's been on the show before. He's currently our longest canine resident. He is a pit chow mix. He's 5 years old. He came to us as a stray, but he had previously been in our shelter twice, it looks like, so we do know a little bit more about him. Currently, Harley is one of the happiest dogs on the floor. He's always got a smile on his face, a little goofy smile. His tail's always wagging. But he's also, like Milo, a little bit overweight. So we have him on a special diet here so that we can kind of get him down to a healthier weight. We're also having him go outside and get a little more time in the play yard, getting more walks so that he's getting more exercise. Because he's 5 years old, Harley is technically a senior here at Animal Control. But as you can see, he's still got a lot of energy. He doesn't necessarily behave like a senior. He likes to play with toys. He loves affection. But things that are important to know about Harley, not just does he have all these great qualities where he's a very happy dog, he's a very playful dog, he loves to be petted and he loves to give kisses, but there are also some other things that you need to take into consideration if you're thinking about adding him to your home. Harley can be a little bit selective about who he wants to be his canine friends. So if you have a dog at home, again, you wanna make sure that you're doing that meet and greet to see if your dog is gonna get along well with Harley. So if you're interested in Harley, please stop by and visit him here at Frederick County Animal Control and Pet Adoption Center. We know that he would love to meet you. So this is gonna wrap it up for this half of the show. We hope you stay tuned and come back and meet some of the great cats that we have available for adoption here as well.
Frederick County Parks and Recreation for some hands-on cooking classes at the Ballinger Creek Community Building in Frederick, Maryland. Some of the classes offered include cooking with your kids in our parent and child programs, have a night with your significant other in our date night classes, learn cuisines from around the world, or learn some basic cooking techniques. For more information, visit us at recreator.com or call 301-600-2936. We'll see you in the kitchen.
Welcome back. Now we have five of the cats that are looking for new forever homes here at Frederick County Animal Control. Four of our guests are going to be residents that live here in the shelter, and we're also going to do something new. We're going to showcase one of our foster cats as well, who is available for adoption but is living off-site in a quieter environment in a foster home. But first up, we have one of our live-in residents. This is Foxy. Mm-hmm. And Foxy's actually been in the shelter before. She's what we would call a return to shelter. She was adopted out back in 2016, but now she's made her way back here. And we're hoping that we can find her a good final forever home where she will spend the rest of her life. She is a brown tabby with white, and she is a 2-year-old domestic short hair. Right away, the first time I saw Foxy, she grabbed my attention. She's got great markings. You know, not only does she have the great tabby cat M on her face, but she's got that great white stripe down her nose. So she's really striking. She's really a beautiful cat, and she's also got a beautiful personality. She's very soft. She has a lot to offer a family like all of our pets here. Because she's already been spayed, she's going to be a relatively quick adoption because we don't have to worry about getting her on our surgery schedule. As we've mentioned in the first half of the show, all of our animals leave here spayed and neutered. So that's something that we will take care of for you as part of your adoption fee. The cats are generally adopted for a fee of $97.50. But when we start talking about our senior residents, then we start getting into some discounts in the adoption fees in increments of $20 based on their age. Foxy came to us because they were moving. She was, a little stressed in that environment there. They were unable to take her, so they brought her to us. According to them, she's calm. She can be a lap cat. She's kind of settling in, but she's also kind of interested in getting down and seeing what's going on here in this big room. She's also was a little bit anxious about leaving her cage. A lot of times the animals get accustomed to living in their cages here in the shelter. They feel safe there. So when you take them out, makes them a little uneasy and they kind of fight to get back in there. So that's something that you want to think about when you're visiting animals here on our adoption floor. If you are interested in adopting and adding super affectionate and gorgeous Foxy to your home, please stop by and visit her here at the shelter. We are open 6 days a week. Our next guest is Black Bean, and Black Bean cannot actually be seen here at the shelter because she is one of the animals that we have in our foster care program. Most of the time, those animals are underage kittens, the kittens that are not yet old enough to be on the adoption floor that are still getting used to acclimating to jumping up, and sometimes they're still unweaned and they're there with their moms, all those types of things. But we also use foster care to help other animals, older animals. Sometimes they're animals that are recovering from a surgery. Sometimes, as in the case of Black Bean here, they're animals that are very scared in the shelter environment and just don't do well here. So we've taken Black Bean from the shelter and put her into a foster home where she has a much quieter environment. She's getting used to new situations, becoming more confident, learning how to love being around people and those types of things. So people who are interested in Black Bean could obviously, we're still trying to adopt her into a loving home. But they would have to call and make an appointment to see her, and then her foster care provider would then bring her in for any potential adopters to interact with her. Black Bean is very, very sweet. She's a three-year-old domestic short hair. She's black, as you can see. She loves to be petted. Her previous owner said that she loves, one-on-one attention with her owners. So she likes to be with people. She just doesn't always want to be sitting on your lap or sitting on your chest. She's more of the, I'm gonna sit at your feet, I'm gonna sit next to you on the couch kind of a cat. But she, she's starting to show us a little bit that she's a little uneasy here. She's been out for a while, we've been filming some B-roll. She's a little bit anxious right now. And that's part of why she's living in a foster home, because we wanna make her feel safe. We don't want her to be so uncomfortable. And fortunately, we have enough foster homes that we can provide her with that until we get her a new forever home. She is 3 years old, so she's got a nice long life ahead of her. Her previous owners brought her in because she wasn't getting along with the other cats in the house. Mostly they were picking on her. So it still remains to be seen whether it's she doesn't get along with other cats or those cats didn't like her. That's just something to consider. We're gonna have flyers throughout the shelter, and you can also see information about Black Bean on our various websites that have our adoptable animals on there, Facebook and the like. So if you are interested in taking home this very sweet cat who probably would do best in a quieter home, you can read all of that information and then contact us, and we can set up an appointment for you to visit with her personally. But this is Black Bean, and she is one of our foster cats looking for a new forever home. This is Cedar. She is one of our senior residents. We talked about a little earlier about how senior residents get discounts in their adoption fee. Cedar, we have aged at approximately 7 to 8 years old because she was a stray, so we don't know her exact age. We're guessing based on her teeth and her musculature, those types of things. So because of that, she would be going home for a $20 reduction in her adoption fee. So that's going to put her at $77.50 instead of that normal $97.50. Important things to note about Cedar, other than her obvious kind of sweet and mellow demeanor, she is declawed in the front. So if you are if you are looking for a cat that's declawed, you might want to come in and check out Cedar. We don't advocate that procedure here at the shelter because it is hurtful for the animals, but we can't undo what's already been done. So if that's something that you're interested in, you can stop in and visit with Cedar. Piper is also front declawed, one of the animals that we've had on the show in the past. So you're also going to want to make sure that you're keeping her inside. She cannot be an indoor-outdoor cat because she doesn't have that primary method of defense. We don't want her to get hurt because she can't protect herself in the outdoors. Another thing that you might notice, when you look at her mouth kind of turns in a little bit. That's because she's missing her upper canines. So that's just a unique quirk to her appearance. Doesn't make her any less beautiful. She's got the great tabby cat markings. She's got that nice long medium coat and the little tufts in her ears. She's just a very striking, a very gorgeous cat, very soft. As you can see, she's perfectly content being a lap cat, letting Randy love on her. She's not really trying to get away. This is Cedar. She's very sweet. She's quickly becoming a volunteer favorite. Every time I walk by her cage, I see someone there giving her some love and attention. If you want to be the one that is always giving Cedar love and attention, stop in and visit her here at Animal Control. You can put in an application for the animals 6 days a week. Our next guest is KK, and she's a little bit shy when you first meet her, but she warms up really quickly. Right now she's in a new space. There's been a lot of loud noises. So she's kind of taken to a safe spot there in the corner of the chair. Normally she's not necessarily this shy, but because of the loud noises that she's recently been experiencing here, she's a little bit more reserved, especially since this is a new space. A lot of times the shyer animals feel more comfortable in their cages, as we've talked about already on the show, because that's the place that they're familiar with. That's where they spend most of their time. KK is a previously owned cat. She's 1 to 2 years old. She's black and white, domestic short hair. She has some great markings. She's got the little spot on the bridge of her nose, that little white spot. And she's got white paws on her feet. She's got those little white socks. But my favorite and one of Randy's favorite things about her is those big, long white whiskers. They just are really striking. They really stand out in contrast to her nice black coat. She's a very sweet girl. One of our kennel techs wrote a nice little note about her in her profile, talking about how she can be a little shy at first. Kind of hangs out in the back of her cage, but as soon as you start petting her, she really enjoys that. She warms right up, she comes to the front of her cage and wants to continue getting that attention. She really enjoys the attention of people. But as we always talk about, you just have to give them that minute, that 60 seconds of where you're standing there, engaging them, letting them know that you're a safe person so that they can show you their true personalities. A lot of the staff here tell me how sweet KK is, and she's definitely showing that off right now. But she still has that little bit of an adventurous side, whether she's just trying to escape to feel safe or she wants to go exploring. When we first brought her in, she was looking to climb up Randy and get onto the top of the chair. So she has that in her. According to her previous owner, she can be pretty independent, but she can also be a lap cat. She's kind of like most of the animals here, and what's typical of cats, they make up their own minds. They do what they want to do when they want to do it. So some days she might want to be by herself, and some days she might want to be your sidekick for the entire day. They say that she is playful, and that she has a bit of energy to her, but they also note what we've seen here, that she can be shy and a little bit afraid of strangers. So if you think that KK is the cat that you've been looking for, and you want to make her part of your family, stop by and visit her here at the shelter. The last guest that we have for you today is Babar, and he is a super sweet guy. When he first came in, he was really scared, and he spent some time in what we call a wild box. But the staff here worked with him and gave him time to acclimate, and then he made his way onto the adoption floor, and now he's just a really sweet, mellow guy. He kind of just hangs out there. It didn't take him very long to come out of his carrier today and make his way onto Randy's lap, and then he immediately started purring. He's, you know, he's quite content to be a lap cat there and get all kinds of love and affection from Randy. Because Babar came to us as a stray, we don't really know much about him. We're learning things about him. You know, even right now, we're learning things about him that we didn't know before. If you're thinking about adding him to your home, if he's gonna be the cat that's gonna make your family complete, then you're gonna have to do the same and just kind of take it as it comes and learn as you go along. Babar, we've aged him to be about 1 to 2 years old. He's a black and white, domestic short hair. He's got, you know, great markings again as well. He's got those black spots that have the kind of salt and pepper white flecked through it, and he's got a nice, great, long black tail. He's just got a really sweet face, very gentle look to him. Babar settled in quite nicely here on the show, telling Randy what he wants as far as where he wants to be petted, making biscuits or kneading, as some people would call. Is he purring? He's purring too. So he's quite content. So if this is what you're looking for, you know, a nice companion to sit on your lap and hang out on a rainy day or a cold evening, or just someone to help you relax after at the end of a long day, stop by and visit with Babar, because he could be the perfect match for you. That's going to wrap it up for this week's edition of Pet Pals. We do want to remind you of some upcoming events. The first event is going to be the Frederick Community College Talent Show. Those students have decided that they want to support us and the animals here at the shelter. So all of the proceeds that come from their talent show in April are going to come back to the shelter animals. And we're going to be there probably with some adoptable kittens and some information that we can provide anybody that's interested in potentially adopting from us. We also have our rabies clinic coming up. That's going to be Sunday, April 23rd. It is Frederick County law that your animals have to be licensed, and it's Maryland state law that they have to have that rabies vaccine. So if your animals are not current, that's a low-cost opportunity to get them both their rabies vaccine and their license. That's going to be for both cats and dogs. And we also offer a microchipping clinic at that time. For $15, you can get your animals microchipped as well. And then the last thing, Memorial Day weekend, we have our open house. So we're inviting you to come and see what animal control is all about. The facility will be open for you to walk through. We'll also have some other local vendors on our property, have some games for the kids, fun things like that. We'll have some food. So it's just gonna be a great time. We invite you and all of your families to come and visit with us on that occasion. But thanks for watching, and we'll see you next week.